channel, and in this video we are going to discuss about why transformer is called a negative feedback device. Yes, in the last class we have discussed why the transformer is called a phase shifting device, and now I'm doing this video on request. Okay, let's get started. Basically, a negative feedback means a response to a stimulus which opposes it to maintain stability in the system. So let us see how this happens in a transformer. Consider a two winding transformer. Here I'm giving a sinusoidal voltage V1 at the primary side, and I'm not connecting any load at the secondary side. So right now, considering it at no load condition. Okay, so what happens is, due to this potential difference, a current flows in the primary winding. This is I0, that is no load current, because there is no load connected. So in this case we are considering an ideal transformer, so there is zero resistance for this winding, and since it is purely inductive, this current I0 will be lagging exactly 90 degrees by this V1, and due to this current I0, an MMF will be produced. Let's say the primary is having N1 number of turns and the secondary is having N2 number of turns. What happens is, when this current I0 is flowing through the N1, then a primary MMF will be produced, that is N1 I0. Due to this MMF, a flux is produced in the transformer like this, and let us call it as Phi1, because it is due to the current in the primary. And due to this flux, an EMF is induced in the primary winding, which we call it as E1. And since this flux links with both the primary and the secondary windings, an EMF E2 is produced in the secondary winding. And we have a formula for E, that is E is equals to 4.44 into F into Phi M into N, where F is the frequency and Phi M is the maximum flux and N is the number of turns. So the formula for E1 is E1 equals to 4.44 F Phi M N1, whereas E2 is 4.44 F Phi M N2. So for a fixed frequency and also the number of turns are fixed for a transformer, so we can observe that this EMF is directly proportional to the flux. Okay, now keep it aside. Now consider the second case, that is the transformer on load, that is a load is connected at the secondary winding. Okay, so what happens is, now I'm applying a voltage V1 at the input, that is primary winding. Since the load is connected at the secondary winding, a current I1 flows in the primary, that is, this is the primary current, and due to this primary current, a flux is produced in the core, that is, say Phi. Since this flux is linking with both the primary and the secondary winding, E1 is produced and E2 is produced. Okay, now what happens is, since the load is connected, that is, since it is a closed circuit, I2 starts flowing in the secondary circuit. This I2 is flowing in this circuit, that is, through N2 number of turns. That is, since I2 is flowing through secondary, an MMF, we call this as secondary MMF, is produced in the secondary winding. And due to this, secondary flux is produced, that is, Phi2. This Phi2 is opposing the primary flux, Phi. So what happens is, this Phi2 tries to reduce the flux, that flux Phi reduces. And we know that this EMF is directly proportional to the flux. Due to the reduction in the flux, now EMF also starts decreasing. Say, let us consider this is a non-ideal transformer, that is, the primary winding has a resistance of R, then E1 will be given by formula E1 equals to V minus, that is, V1 minus I1 R. Now, I1 will be given by formula V1 minus E1 by R. So, here we have discussed that this due to the reduction in the flux, this EMF is reducing. So now, due to this reduction in the E, then current starts increasing, because it is in the negative value, because it is after the negative minus sign. Since this value decreases, this current starts increasing. That is, there is an excess current in the primary winding. Due to this excess current in the primary winding, there is a production of excess MMF in the primary winding. Say this, let us consider this excess current to be as I2 dash. Since this current is due to the flow of secondary current I2, let us consider this as I2 dash. Due to this I2 dash, there is an excess MMF in the primary winding, that is N1 I2 dash, because this I2 dash is flowing through the primary winding which has N1 number of turns. So this is the excess MMF, and due to this excess MMF, there is an excess flux produced in the primary winding. Again, I'm considering this as I2 dash because this is due to the current in the secondary winding, that is flux in the secondary winding. So I'm taking it as phi 2 dash, and this phi 2 dash will be exactly equal and opposite to the phi 2. And another point, this phi 2 dash will be supporting the flux, that is in order to maintain the stability in the transformer, that is in order to maintain the same flux in the core, an additional MMF is produced, an additional flux is produced in the primary winding, that is to count as a counter to the secondary flux. This phi 2 dash is exactly equal and opposite to phi 2, whereas it is supporting the flux, which because it is in the same direction. So what happens is, since these are equal in the magnitude, they both gets cancelled, and finally flux will be remained in the core, that is it is maintained constantly throughout the operation of the transformer. This I2 dash is produced at the same instant as the I2, that is I2 and I2 dash are produced instantaneously, and this fluxes gets cancelled instantaneously, and the flux will be maintained constant, that is flux phi will be established in the magnetic core, and hence this is the reason why the transformer has constant core losses or iron losses, because the iron losses depends upon the flux in the transformer core. Anyways, so this is the reason why the transformer is called a negative feedback device, because basically a negative feedback is a reaction that is caused to stabilize the system, that is in response with a stimuli. Like if something is happening, it tries to oppose it in order to maintain the stability, and the same thing is happening here, and hence you can call transformer as a negative feedback device. Okay, to put it in a nutshell, let me explain like this. Initially, due to the load in the transformer, I2 is produced. I2 starts flowing in the secondary current, and due to this I2, this MMF N2 I2 is produced, and this due to this N2 I2, flux phi2 is produced, and since this flux is opposing the primary flux, then primary flux phi starts decreasing, and due to the decrease in the phi, this EMF starts decreasing, and due to the decrease in the EMF, so what happens is the primary current starts increasing. I1 plus I2 dash will be now flowing in the circuit, and due to this additional thing, then additional MMF is produced, and due to this additional flux is produced, and this flux will cancel the phi2, and it will maintain the flux as it is this in the first case. So this is how the transformer is acting as a negative feedback device. I hope it is cleared, and if you have any more doubts, you can comment down in the comment section, and if you like this video, please like it and do share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more kind of these videos, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.